80. Planet X has not been destroyed, as being claimed by some internet radio hosts, simply to gain traction to get more viewers while they lead people astray. Listen forth into this video as it's being explained by that ancient spirit. Trolloc is speaking here in spirit. This video was created to correct to some speakers and on those internet sites on what they're claiming. And this is purely in the cases and efforts to gain traction of popularity while at the same time screwing with their fellow spirit humans in manner so those spirit humans of the rest of the planet are not putting aside as they can afford long-term storable foods and water and goods and go back to a foolhardy life of only getting what you need in the immediate time and forget about planning, of being simple-minded servants of the now and the slap-dancing puppet leaders. This is a horrible time. This is disgusting that people would even think of misleading people this way, especially here in America, for people to get fooled again by radio internet shows who are there mostly for a verbal character of trashy talk, much like reading the monthly gossip magazines on the racks in the storefronts and by their registers. In both cases, a spirit human, I'm asking you to be able to understand the truths from the lies and the propaganda programming that has so much held this planet of spirit humans behind. Those of who are planning these things are the New World Order, who have had much of this propaganda and programming in effect for thousands and thousands of years from their leaders, of which being are a certain species of greys and a certain species of reptilians. It is truly shocking on the degree of penetration of the false programming into people's life. Now, as this presentation goes on here, the ancient spirit Trolloc is very upset as he comes forth and explains the whys of the false propaganda called Planet X has not been destroyed. Also in how they are weaving, interweaving into even the popular radio shows to keep the people acting like sheeple that are just gonna go to their jobs, do what they're told, believe what they're told, pay the banks that they're told, and live a servant life. And who are just barely maintaining so much in America, barely able to maintain just the bare sense of freedom. But yet their inner spirit, they're being tricked, rather, to be put back to sleep, those who are awakening, in a full effort. This is a full effort in the latest push by the New World Order who want to get back the command of the ship of the planet Earth, who lost it late last year to the mass consciousness of the planet, which is operated by the awakened beings of this planet. So, as the ancient spirit Trolloc has talked about in other videos, the actual planet that is within the Earth systems of planets and its other system of planets that is paired to the Earth system of planets. There is no planet called X or a planet X. Yet to go further here, an internet show person who claims to be a 32-degree Mason of a secretive European cult claims on his show with his so-called knowledge that the planet X has been destroyed. But this is just, please understand, this is just a simple goal of gaining traction of more viewers, to be more popular, to forward himself in life, and to heck what damage is doing to the civilization. While purposely misleading his listeners, perhaps he's also getting paid to mislead. Many questions which the public need to go find out. So they will, you know, he wants to mislead his listeners so they stop trying to be prepared as that Nibiru system of planets and its red dead star come across the Earth and Moon's orbit, which is still on its way coming to us. This is a fact. Now here the ancient spirit Trelawka is talking very strict about things as he shares to explain to the spirit humans on this planet Earth, just as in his own past lineage, making sure that other species of beings understood clearly what was being explained to them, depending, of course, on the subject or situations needing some very important guidance or explanations. So, back to the point here. Planet X itself is not real. It is not a red devil. It is not an avenging angel. It is not Judgment Day or the apocalypse or a great mystery of lifting of only good people in the air. This is science in motion. Understand this. This is not religion or cult or belief. This is science in motion as the Nibiru system comes and interacts with us. It is not filled with beings, this illusionary Planet X, of beings who are evil or of evil, because the Planet X itself doesn't exist. It is not the final destruction of Earth because of sinners, which are of those who refuse to be in the crowd of the latest belief or religion. The citizens of planet Earth need to understand this very clearly here now, as it is being yet again explained by the ancient spirit Trelawka. The greatest damaging effect of when the Nibiruan system of planets comes across the paths of the Earth, the Sun, and the Moon is this. The Nibiru system has a red dead star within its system, though giving off yet great heat to the closer planets and moons of that system. It no longer shines like the sun we have in this Earth systems of planets. The red dead star, however, does have a very intense magnetic field. This has for over 500,000 years, according to off-world libraries, give or take, have attracted many, many small-sized moons and even broke some planets up, some within the original system of planets, which used to be of Earth, when the Earth systems of planet was much bigger than it is now, which I explained in some of my videos. But the red dead star has also used its moons and its asteroid field of crunched up planets to crunch up planets in other star systems on its journey. It's how this is working. This is how it is shown, you know, that the other similar systems that have this long tail of asteroids, of most of them pale in comparison to the Nibiru system and its red dead star asteroid field. So does this asteroid field wreak havoc on the other system of planets? As I have said, yes, it does. It has in the past and has a great conjecture of doing it again in the future. So understand that it is not a planet that is destroying things. It is mainly of what is within the Nibiruan asteroid field of both mega-sized and micro-sized planetary parts and moon parts and just plain asteroid parts that never made it into moons that do this damage when the Nibiru system and its tail comes across to a different planetary system of planets. Though here, the last, understand here that the last three moons of the Nibiru system of planets that have in the past been known to have crashed, not crash, but glance, like simple, like a little glance within the magnetic fields of other moons and planets. Though, you know, also sometimes going through big asteroid fields of other planetary system. And then, of course, what happens is that nebulous systems of planets, red, dead star, that asteroid tail gets much longer and much thicker for periods of cycles of time of passing until some of those tail gets lost to other planetary systems. Some could be simply into other asteroid fields, or others could end up being big asteroid showers that could be of devastation. But let us go on and explain what would happen in truthfulness, as understood by an ancient spirit, if that red dead star would explode or be purposely exploded by, let's say, a massive missile attack, or while it was in the inner orbits of the Earth systems of planets. And according to information here from the ancient Trollaca, the red dead star that has such a massive magnetic field would, as exploding into pieces, create such massive rippling magnetic waves which will go across the Earth systems of planets in space that the devastation would be great. I mean, massively great. The side of the Earth that had faced the explosion and the incoming magnetic waves would only death be its future. To explain this understanding in greater depths and understandings of a real exploding red dead star that was exploded on purpose, the waves of the magnetics would slice through all living matter on that side of the Earth's surface it faced. This would kill all vegetation, all landside animal life, and humans. Picture the biggest meat mincer in your mind, and then picture it against the planet Earth in many waves hitting that side of Earth. Even the buildings on the surface would be sliced through like a hot knife through butter. This is horrible. Even to try to mention that it's been destroyed, because this could be effects from the time that red dead star, such as in a nebulous system of planet, being purposely exploded, even if, and that's a big if, a certain species that are natural, whether in the Earth systems of planet or the nebulous system of planets, even could have that level of technology. And I'm saying that the probabilities of even the Burans having that technology, they haven't quite reached yet. And it's a good thing because it's so dangerous. To explode it, let's just per se, as it's coming towards the Earth, or it is just passing, going outwards from the Earth's orbit, would be of such a sudden death to half of the planet Earth's life. As I've said before, the plants, the trees, the vegetation, the crops, the animals, and the humans who live on that side of the surface that the waves of magnetics hit, this would have a period and the probabilities of over 100 years to get that charged side of the planet Earth producing healthy crops again and trees to form as new forests and probably and populating with animals that can survive on their own. Because some of this has to do with those magnetics that would be left over from those giant magnetic waves that would be within the Earth's soil. Now, according to variables of radiations, would be trapped in there also. Although not deadly, the crops, trees, and grazing animals would not be very productive eating from stuff grown from that until it weakened in strength. As this is taught and understood on other worlds within the living universe, this kind of damage, this kind of damage done to a planet that supports life, and or moons that support life and plants and trees and nature could kill that planet's and or moon's cycle of life as it was known to be or to exist. Should something like this coming to a more advanced civilization, great measures would be made far in advance to get as many of its spirit beings off the planets, including samples of the trees, the other vegetations, the vegetables, the animals, and a wide DNA spread of their species of inner spirit living beings of a humanoid or variances others, to get them off the planet to a safe area to hopefully be able to restart their civilization. So one may ask, but if the red dead star of the Nibiru system of planets is in the infrared range, does it mean anything at all that it wouldn't affect Earth? No. No, no, no. I'm telling you from the ancient within spirit to which it will be said. It makes no difference of it being in a three-dimensional vision or infrared vision or other variables. It makes no difference because the red dead star has great mass that would be moved in a very short order if time should a civilization feel they want to destroy it simply because they're a bunch of pricks. The great magnetics, which for millions of years helped to contain this great energy and its secondary magnetics, would ripple outwards from that red dead star in such crippling massive waves of magnetic motions that would lay waste to anything in its path for different periods of time, depending, of course, on the conditions of those planet, moons, and possible suns in its direct course of coming towards. To of which I will say, from the vantage point of an ancient spirit, that the Nibiru systems of planets, red dead star, will each time affect Earth and its sun and planets and moons to a lesser or greater percentage. This difference is for the varied distances that the system will either be closer or farther from the Earth or its systems of planets and moons and sun. For please truly understand from an ancient's point of view that no orbits of a secondary system or any system at all, even if it has a secondary sun or a red dead star within it someplace lingering around or different variables of it, will not be in the same orbit twice in a row. Yearly cycled orbit, because of the much higher understandings of science on much higher dimensional worlds that understand that all orbits of systems, whether it be a star system one sees in the astrology, in the night skies, no matter where they may be living in the living universe, or understandings of the astrology of movements of the stars, it is a much higher dimensional species understanding that this is many times what is showed and showing here that the universe is alive because it is always in motion. Everything within it is always in motion in one aspect or another, in one dimension or another, all going on at the same time, as it continually creates or recycles. The living universe wastes nothing over the long expanses, as even new versions of species of life come into applications within the living universe, or as others who have such civilizations that have such age to such age, such oldness, to desire to, as a whole group, to begin to fully different understood cycle of life somewhere in a living universe that they desire to move to, and they manifest through this process. So back to the original point that some radio internet hosts have claimed that the planet X is destroyed. This is a lie. This is deception. This is used against you to trick you not to be prepared. The ancient spirit Trelawka here is very firm in the present moment, saying it's only happening within those drug-induced minds that believe that the planet X has been destroyed, simply to try to gain traction of having more people listening to their programs. This is horrible. This is wrong. Though, as the ancient spirit continues, for the true preservation of Earth's spirit human's future, this foolhardy drug reasoning of radio hosts that claimed such foolhardiness as Planet X is destroyed must remain only as their drug-induced personal fantasies, lest they be condemning you and at least half of your own species of spirit humans to horrific physical deaths that could or will take lifetimes for the inner spirit beings who were affected, who horribly had their physical bodies ripped apart, for those inner spirit beings to recover. As always, my friends, journey safely. Journey to many worlds to expand your true wisdom, to clear oneself from the false propaganda programming on this planet Earth. Become awake of your inner spirit, of your outer expression, and joining in the greater understanding with your inner spirit expression. Become better than the parts of you once divided by the programming lies. This is the ancient spirit, Trelawka. Good night.